Hi, a very happy morning to one and all present for this webinar. Myself Krishna Kumar and I will be the host for this webinar. I hereby welcome everybody for this webinar on medical data analysis using AI, artificial intelligence, organized by Science Forum from Government First Grade College, Malur. So hereby I heartfully welcome our respected principal sir, Professor Jairam Reddy for this webinar. Welcome sir. And I hereby welcome our organizing secretary people of Science Department, Mr. Nagareddy BY, Department of Mathematics, Mrs. Anuradha P, Department of Physics, Mr. Kantraj KS, Department of Physics, and Dr. Hamila K, Department of Computer Science. So now finally, I hereby welcome our most talented and most skilled English resource person for this webinar. He is a data analyst, a data developer, and an ML practitioner. He has very much skilled and very much talented person. He is expertised in Python language, cloud computing, and is also working on IBM clouds, IBM cloud computing, and Google cloud computing. He has trained more than 4,000 students on his career in various technologies. So I hereby welcome our resource person, Mr. Heflin Stephen Raj, for this webinar. I heartfully welcome you, sir. And hereby, I welcome our fellow participants for this webinar and I cordially invite all the teaching and non-teaching staff for this webinar. Before starting the webinar, I have few instructions for all the participants. All the participants will be getting the participation certificate and the link is present in the description box and even the chat box. So the live chat is on. So any doubts, you can ask in the chat box. Unnecessary chats are not allowed. Please do cooperate and I thank everybody for this session and handing over this session to you, sir. Thank you.
Hi there. Welcome to the webinar on medical data analysis using artificial intelligence without coding. I would like to thank Principal of Government First Grade College, Professor Jairam Reddy and organizing secretaries for organizing this webinar. As the webinar's title says, we are going to use artificial intelligence to analyze the medical data such as scan reports and images. Don't worry, my dear friends, we are not going to write any coding. Not even single line of code. Yeah, you heard me right. In this workshop, we are going to use cloud technologies to analyze the medical data without writing the code. Please post your doubts and questions in the comment section. I am here to clear all your doubts and answer your questions. Once you fill the feedback form, your e-certificate of completion will be directly delivered to your email ID. What are you waiting for? Let's get into the webinar. Those who don't know me, here is my quick intro. I am Heflin Stephen Raj. I am very passionate about technologies. I learned everything on my own from the internet at free of cost during last year's lockdown. Then I got an offer letter from Webnext for chatbot developer and data analytics. Now I'm working there as a chatbot developer and data analytics. And I also passionate about teaching. So I started to take YouTube channels to share my knowledge with everyone on the internet. One in English, another one in Tamil. I have trained more than 4,100 candidates on various tech domains. Finally, I am a second year BCA student. If you want to contact me or to get to know more about me, please visit my website at www.heflin.dev. Here is the agenda for this webinar. First, we will talk about cloud computing and its use cases, because we are going to use cloud technologies in this webinar. Then, we will look into what is visual recognition and how visual recognition is useful in medical industry. Then we will use Google Teachable Machine to detect the mask. Then we will use IBM Watson Visual Recognition to detect the marks. And we also use IBM Watson Visual Recognition to detect the brain tumors in the brain scan reports. Finally, we will use Google's Data Studio for analyzing the COVID cases. Quite interesting, right? I'm very much excited. What about you? Let me know in the comment section. Let's get started. Before stepping into cloud computing, I would like to talk about why do we need data analytics in the medical industry. The application of data analytics in healthcare has a lot of positive and also life-saving outcomes. In essence, big style data refers to the vast quantities of information created by the digitalization of everything that gets consolidated and analyzed by specific technologies. Applied to healthcare, it will use specific health data of your population and potentially help to prevent epidemics, cure diseases, cut down costs, etc. Now that we live longer, treatment models have changed, and many of these changes are namely driven by data. Doctors want to understand as much as they can about a patient and as early in their life as possible to pick up warning signs of serious illness as they arise. Treating any diseases at an early stage is far more simple and less expensive. Finally, doctors' decisions are becoming more and more evidence-based, meaning that they rely on large research and clinical data as opposed to slowly their schooling and professional opinion. I hope now you will be cleared why do we need data analytics in the healthcare. Now let's jump into cloud computing. Cloud computing is the on-demand availability of computer system resources, especially data storage and computing power, without direct active management by the user. The term is generally used to describe data centers available to many users over the internet. This is what Wikipedia says about cloud computing. Let me explain cloud computing with a real-life example. Let's assume that we are going shopping now. We have two options to travel from one place to another. One is private transport such as car and bike. Another one is public transport, includes buses, trains, and shared autos. In public transport, you and other passengers pay for the ticket to reach your destination. You don't have to worry about the fuel and the bus conditions and other parameters. And you don't own the bus, so you don't have full control over it. Whereas in private transport, you have to buy your car or bike, you have to pay for the maintenance, and you also have to pay for the fuel. But your bike is yours, right? So you have complete control over it. Like that, you can either go for cloud computing or on-premise servers. Just like public transport, in cloud computing, you don't have to pay for the servers and server maintenance. Since these servers are owned by cloud providers such as Google, IBM, Microsoft, Amazon, Oracle, Salesforce, etc., you don't have full control over the servers. Just like private transport, you have to pay for the servers and server maintenance. But since you own the server, you have full control over it. I hope now you will be clear with the cloud computing concept. Let's move to visual recognition. If I asked you to name the objects on the screen, you would probably come up with a list of words such as tablecloth, basket, grass, boy, girl, man, woman, orange juice bottle, tomatoes, disposable plates, blah blah blah, without thinking twice. Now, if I told you to describe the picture, you would probably say it is the picture of a family picnic, again without giving it a second chance. Digital equipment can capture images at resolutions and with detail that far surpass the human vision system. Computers can also detect and measure the difference between colors with very high accuracy. But making sense of the content of those images is probably that computers have been struggling with for decades. To a computer, the picture is an array of pixels or numerical values that represent colors. Visual recognition is the field of computer science that focuses on replicating parts of the complexity of the human vision system and enabling computers to identify and process objects in the images and videos in the same way that humans do. Until recently, computer vision only worked in limited capacity. Thanks to advance in artificial intelligence and innovation in deep learning and neural networks, the field has been able to take great leaps in recent years and has been able to suppress humans in some tasks related to detecting and labeling objects. We are already using visual recognition to make self-driving cars. But why do we need visual recognition in the healthcare? In recent times, various institutions, including governments, are facing a lot of problems in ensuring that everyone is following the COVID protocols, such as wearing masks, social distances, and hand sanitizers. Here, the visual recognition plays a vital role. We can use visual recognition to detect face mark, and even we can use visual recognition to analyze various scan reports and x-rays. Interesting, right? We are going to do that same thing in this webinar. Let's jump into the demo section. Now, this is the time for our first demo. Now, we are going to use Google Teachable Machine to detect masks. Let's get started. Open up your browser and go to teachablemachine.withgoogle.com. You can also find the link in the description section. Google Teachable Machine is Google's free no-code deep learning model creation website. You can build models to classify images, audios, or even poses. After doing the same, you can download the trained model and use it for your applications. You can use the webcam to capture images or uploading existing images from your machine. The browser simply relies on your machine's inbuilt microphones to capture 10 seconds of audio samples for sound. You can train models that can detect your hand movements and body poses all the way from your webcam. There are three steps involved in training a model with Google Teachable Machine at a high level: gathering the samples, training the model, testing and improving the model. Gathering the samples feeds the algorithm with enough data for the training. Training takes place within the browser. The data stays in your machine without being moved to the cloud. Finally, you can tweak the model to improve its accuracy. You can add more samples and retrain to increase prediction accuracy. The best part of Teachable Machine is the ability to export the model to various environments and applications. You can easily export the model as a TensorFlow.js model and host it on Teachable Machine for free so that you can use it with any website or mobile applications. In this demo, we are going to create a website that can detect masks in real time. I'm repeating, don't worry guys, we are not going to do any coding for this. To do so, click on the Get Started. From here, you can choose your project. Now, I'm going to choose the image project to detect the face marks. First, I will name the class. To edit the name of the class, just click on the pencil icon next to the class and enter your name. I name it to Mask. Now you can either upload the pictures or open your webcam and take pictures. Let me take photos of myself with a mask. Just hold the button to take multiple pictures at a time. Now we are going to do the same for the no mask class. Rename the class to no mask. Open the webcam to take photos of myself without the mask. That's it. Here we have options to change the parameters for our machine learning model. I leave it as default. Click on the train model button. This will use Google's TensorFlow.js to develop the deep learning model So this will take some time. That's it. Our model is trained successfully. Now we can test out our model. As you can see, our model is detecting the mask perfectly. Now let's move to the export model section. Just click on the export model. Now we are going to upload our model so that we can use it from anywhere without downloading the model on our local machine. Just click on the upload my model under tensorflow.js. Please note, your training data will not be uploaded to the internet. Now our model is uploaded. Let's test it out. Just copy the raw JavaScript code. Open a notepad on your local machine and paste it. And save the notepad as an HTML file. That's it. Now we are done. Open the HTML file and have fun with your mask detection website. Back to the teachable machine. Now we are going to test out the P5 JavaScript format of our machine learning code. P5.js is a JavaScript library for creative coding with a focus on making coding accessible and inclusive for artists, designers, educators, beginners, and anyone. Just go to P5.js and do the same. Open your notepad on your local machine and paste it. Save the notepad as an HTML file. Now let's check out the p5.js version of our website. This looks cool, right? Let me know your reaction in the comment section. Back to our slides. You can use this tool, Google Teachable Machine, to develop an artificial intelligence application without developing the AI on your own. We also have another no-code AI platform, that is Loop from Microsoft. To check out Loop, just go to loop.ai from your browser. This tool is similar to Google's Teachable Machine. I leave this tool to you guys. Check out this tool on your own after this webinar and let me know your outputs in the comment section. Back to our slides. Now we are going to use IBM Watson visual recognition to detect masks, and we are also going to use the same service, that is IBM Watson visual recognition service, to analyze scan reports to detect brain tumors. Let's get started. Open up your browser, go to cloud.ibm.com. If you already have an IBM cloud account, you can simply log into that and use that account for this webinar. If you don't have an IBM cloud account, don't worry guys, you can create a new one that is for free. Now I'm going to log in into my account. As soon as you log into IBM Cloud account, you will land on IBM Cloud dashboard. From here, go to the search bar, search for visual recognition, and click on the visual recognition from the list. Now we are going to provision our IBM Watson visual recognition service. IBM Cloud offers various cloud services for free. In this webinar, we are going to use IBM Watson visual recognition service for free. Scroll down. If you want, you can rename the service. Then click on create button. That's it. We have successfully provisioned our IBM Watson visual recognition service. Just click on launch Watson Studio. If you are using the visual recognition service for the first time, you have to set up your IBM Cloud pack for data. If you are a student, please provide your college name as your company name. If you are a professional, you can enter your company name. Then enter your phone number. Then click on create. Now we are going to choose the service. Just select Watson Machine Learning Service. Then click on continue. Now IBM Cloud is provisioning our IBM Cloud pack for data. That's it. Let's go to IBM Cloud pack for data. Now we can use IBM Watson Visual Recognition Service. IBM Watson Visual Recognition Service offers various visual recognition machine learning model to classify and detect objects in images. IBM Cloud offers three pre-built models. One to analyze general images, another one for food images, and finally we have a machine learning model to classify explicit images. Now we are going to detect face masks. So for that, I'm going to create a classify image model. Click on create model under classify image. Just name your project. The name could be anything. If you want, you can add project description. That is optional. Then finally click on create button. Now IBM Cloud is creating a project for our custom visual recognition model. We have successfully created our custom visual rendition model. Just rename the model name. The name could be anything. I have a zip file that contains images with mask and without mask. Now I'm going to upload that zip file. Now our images are being uploaded to the IBM Cloud Visual Recognition Service. As soon as you create a IBM Cloud Visual Recognition Service, a separate service for storage will be created, and that service is known as IBM Cloud Object Storage. All the images are being uploaded to the IBM Cloud Object Storage Service. Once all the images are uploaded, you can rename the class. Here we have another class, that is negative. Use this negative class to train the model on images that do not come under any of predefined class. Yeah, all the images are uploaded. So now I'm going to click on train model button. This will take some time, so please be hold on. Our model is trained successfully. Now we can test out our model as well as we can implement our model in our application. Now we are going to test out our machine learning model performance. For that, click on the name of your machine learning project. Under Asset tab, go to Models and click on the name of your machine learning model. Here you can get the details of your machine learning model. Go to test. Now we are going to upload two images to test the performance of our machine learning model. As you can see, our machine learning model successfully classified the image. You can see the confidence score for each classification. Go to implementation tab. Here you can get the code snippet for all the popular programming language. You can use this code to implement in your application. Now we are going to use IBM Watson Visual Recognition Service to detect brain tumors in brain scan images. For that, click on the name of your project. Under Asset tab, go to Models and click on New Visual Recognition Model. And now we are going to detect brain tumors in brain scan images. For that, click on Create Model under Detect Objects. Then we are going to upload the images. Click on the image icon next to the question mark icon and click on Browse. I have downloaded few images from the internet. Yeah, that's it. We have added 10 brain tumors images. Now we are going to label it. Click any one of the image. Let me zoom out little bit. Click on Add Objects. Label the object that is brain tumor. And name the label. Then click on Add button. Repeat this for all the images. Click on Add Objects. Label the brain tumor. Name the brain tumor and click on Add. Once you have labeled all the brain tumors, you can click on Done button. Let's get back to our visual recognition model. Click on Train Model. This will take some time. Now our visual recognition model's training is completed. Here you can click on this link to test your model performance. Here you can get the details of your machine learning model, that is visual recognition model. Go to test. And now I'm going to upload an image to test the performance of our visual recognition model. As you can see, our visual recognition model detected few brain tumors. Just increase the threshold to get the best result. Yeah, our visual recognition model has successfully detected the brain tumors. Go to the Implementation tab, Here you can get the code snippet to implement this visual recognition model on your application. Back to our slides, guys. Now we came into the last demo of this webinar. In this demo, we are going to use Google Data Studio to analyze the COVID data. Before jumping into Google Data Studio, I would like to introduce the data. We are going to analyze this COVID data. This COVID data contains name of the state, country, last update, longitude, latitude, confirmed cases, deaths, number of recovered cases, number of active cases, combined key, incident rate, case fatality ratio, and FIPS. FIPS stands for Federal Information Processing Standard State Code. This data is obtained from Center for System Science and Engineering, Johns Hopkins University, America. This is CSV data. Let me open the original view of this data. Before that, what is CSV data? Well, abbreviation of CSV is comma separated values. CSV file is a delimited text file that uses comma to separate values. Each line of your file is a data record. Each record consists of one or more fields separated by commas. Well, back to our CSV data. Just have a look at this data. Are you able to understand the data? It is tough to get the information from this data, right? That's why data analysts and developers are creating dashboard to understand the COVID data. A dashboard is a type of graphical user interface that often provides at a glance view of key performance indicators relevant to a particular objective or business process. Let me show the COVID dashboard developed by World Health Organization, WHO. This is quite impressive and informative, right? By looking at this data, that is dashboard, you can easily understand number of new COVID cases, confirmed cases, deaths, and vaccination. If you scroll down, you can view various graphs and comparative visualization to understand the COVID data even better. We are going to create a dashboard that looks like this in this demo. Are you excited? I'm very excited. Let's jump into Google Studio. Open up your browser. Go to datastudio.google.com. You can also find the link in the description section. Let me introduce Google Studio. Google Data Studio as the data visualization software you need to connect your data, create data dashboards, and collaborate to answer your most important questions. Click on blank report. If you are using Data Studio for the first time, you will be asked to enter your company name as well as your country. If you are a student, just enter your college name. If you are a working professional, you can enter your company name. And now I'm going to upload the CSV file to Google Data Studio. Click on File Upload. Click on Upload File. Choose the file. Now our file is being uploaded to Google Data Studio. Once the file is uploaded, you can click on Add button. As soon as you add data to your Google Data Studio, it will automatically create a table representing your data. Now we are going to edit this default table to show the total number of confirmed cases by countries. For that, go to Dimensions, change FIPS to Country Region, then go to Metric, change Record Count to Confirmed Case. This will sum of all the confirmed cases by countries. Here you can see total number of confirmed cases by countries. Just like this, we can create amazing data dashboards and reports with Google Data Studio with few steps. Now we are going to add a pie chart to showcase total number of death cases by countries. To add a chart, click on Add a Chart from the toolbar, select pie chart and place the pie chart wherever you want. By default, the pie chart takes the total number of confirmed cases. To change this, go to Metric, change the confirmed to death. That's it. By default, the aggregation of metric is sum. If you want to edit that, click on pencil icon. The available options are sum, average, count, count distinct, minimum, maximum, medium, standard deviation, and variance. If you want, you can also change the type of the data column. We also have options to change the style of our visualization. To change the style of our pie chart, just go to Style tab. Here we have so many options to change our pie chart style. Now I'm going to increase the font size of the label. Now it is easy to read, right? We have style option for all the visualization. So if you want, you can change the style for all the visualization. Now I'm going to add a text in this report. For that, click on text icon from the toolbar and place the text wherever you want and enter the text. We can also change font size and font style of this text box. Now I'm going to add a scoreboard to get the sum of all the confirmed cases on April 5, 2021. For that, click on Add a Chart button from the toolbar, select Scoreboard Total, then place the scoreboard. By default, it takes deaths, so I'm going to change it to confirmed case. Like this, I'm going to add another scoreboard for death. Now I'm going to insert a drop-down list box. This drop-down list box will be used to select countries. To insert drop-down list box, click on Insert button from the menu bar and select drop-down list box and place the drop-down list box on our report. Let me change the layout of our report. Drop-down list box as a control field. In this control field, you have to provide the data column. Here, by default, it is country region. We leave it as a default because we need to select countries. To check out drop-down list box, click on View button. Wow, our data report is looking good, right? Let me know your reaction in the comment section. Now let's have a look at our drop-down list box. Now I need data for India, US, Russia, Brazil. See, our report has been updated. Our report has data for US, Brazil, India, and Russia. Back to edit mode. You can also embed a website in your report. To do so, click on URL embed icon from the toolbar and place the URL embed widget. You can also resize your URL embed widget. Now I'm going to enter my website domain name here. Let's have a look at our dashboard. It is looking so good, right? We can also interact with the dashboard. Just have a look at this dashboard, guys. Oh, I forgot to give a name for our report. Back to edit mode. Give a name for your report. COVID report. That's it. If you want to share this report with anyone, you can have options to share this report with invitation. Or you can also have an option to schedule an email to share this report, or else you can generate a link to share this report, or you can embed this report on your website, or you can download this report. And now I go with link. Let me copy the link. Open up your browser, paste the link. Let's check out our report. It looks like we need to enable public access to our report. Let me enable public access to our report now. Change sharing setting. Go to manage access. Now select the public access. Anyone on the internet can find and view this. Click on save and copy the URL. Now you are good to go. Now you can share this URL to send the report. Google Data Studio has a lot of visualization options to enable your data in an informatic way. In few minutes, we have created an informatic data report. I leave the link to this report in the description section. Check out if you want. Back to our slides. With this, we came to the end of this webinar. I hope you'll all learn something new from this webinar. Please fill out the feedback form to receive your certificate. You can find the feedback form link in the description section. I would like to thank the principal of Government First Grade College, Jayaraman Reddy, and organizing secretaries for organizing this webinar. If you have any doubts or questions, please let me know in the comment section, or else if you want to contact me, you can contact me on Instagram, Facebook, LinkedIn, and Twitter. All the links are given in the description section. Please take a second to provide me your comments about this webinar in the comment section. This webinar video is available on YouTube forever, so if you want to watch it again, you can do so. Thank you, stay safe, wear mask, and keep learning. Over to Aman Kumar.
Hello everyone. A warm and cherished morning to our most valued honorable resource, Mr. FN Stephen Raj, principal, faculty members, my dear friends and everyone present here. It's my privilege to propose a vote of thanks and acknowledge the contribution of those who worked hard to make this webinar grand success. This is Hemant Kumar Asan from second year BSc, Government First Grade College, Malur. I'm here to give the vote of thanks for today's webinar on medical data analysis using artificial intelligence. Firstly, we are heartily thankful to our beloved principal, Professor Jayaram Reddy M. Thank you, sir, who always motivated us and always supporting us in any activities we are doing. Once again, thank you, sir. I take this time to thank our resource person, Mr. Heffen Stephen Raj. Thank you, sir, for sharing your knowledge on medical data analysis using artificial intelligence with all of us. This webinar was really useful to us, sir. We learned much things on medical data analysis using artificial intelligence, where it was a new topic to us. Surely we will utilize this class, sir. Once again, thank you, sir. I wholeheartedly like to thank our beloved science faculties, Mr. Nagareddy B.Y. Thank you, sir. Mistress Anuradha P. Thank you, ma'am. Mr. Kantraj K.S. Thank you, sir. Dr. Hemila K. Thank you, ma'am. And also guest faculties who made this webinar possible for us. And also like to thank all the faculties, teaching and non-teaching staff who made this seminar to reach us. Once again, thank you to all. Last but not least, without you that no program will be successful, friends. Thanks to all who were present here and made the webinar successful. Thank you to all. Dear friends, the feedback form is shared in chat box and also in description. Please kindly fill it. Thank you. Have a nice day. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you, one and all.